Alright. So he's champ 3 in ones, but he was champ 2 here. There's a lot of goals. Interesting. Good flicks, thanks for asking. It's always good to see you, Kurt. I don't know why I'm flying script punches to watch, I don't usually use that word. I hear that opinion a lot. Hide your cookies, you should watch out. Sonar Mountain, or I'll call you Solar or Sonar. If you're on tabs right now, bro, this might not be the content to watch if you're tripping, dog. So if you're tripping, I was giving a heads up, dog, right? Alright. I don't want to bad trip you. Alright, nice. Kick over. Gotta bounce. Have a good night, chat. Yeah, I'm sorry, Hydro. I'm sorry, dog, for not doing it. We'll do it soon. I don't want to scam you, dude. Thank you for being here, man. Have a good night, dude. Thanks for the gifted subs as well today. So, this is the best shit to watch. Shut the hell up. How do you do that, Sonar, on that shit, man? I'm like, I can't. Right. You should land here and flip into the ball. You land, like, here, and then you jump. Your jump is scuffed. If you don't have enough time, then you side flip. Make sure you diagonal flip through the ball. I don't know if Calm still plays. You mean Calms or Calm? Because Calm still plays. Alright, don't get too desperate. I would have pressured him instead of going for the boost here, man. Like, what you should do is grab a pad here. Like, you grab a pad, you hit the ball here, right? You grab this pad, and then you let the ball roll like this, and then you power slide cut it if he challenges. You could hook shot it. You could put a lot of pressure on him, and you can allow him to not get boost. If you go for mid boost, you allow him to grab boost as well. So what you should do, in my opinion, is hit the ball here. Softly, you grab this pad, and then if he challenges, power slide cut. Otherwise, like hook shot it or something. But you don't allow him to just go for boost like this for free. Why am I watching him, though? So, if you want to dribble, you dribble here. Go under the ball and dribble, right? If this happens, this is now a bounce dribble. It is either you touch the ball after the bounce and you go for it, or you wait back and you dribble after the ball bounces like this, and now you go under the ball and now you try to dribble it. I don't know what you tried to do, but at this point you should notice he can challenge. He's come down the wall and he's going for the ball. So it means you should now jump up behind the ball on low 50, or like fake, or like anything, but you can't like still get under the ball and like still try to flick it over him, because you don't have the fucking time for that, right? You don't challenge that. The second he leaves, he leaves. So if you push up and you go, like, you can see the moment where he leaves, right? You push up, this is enough, he's gonna leave now. And if he stays here, it's good. Low 50 is literally good. You're in the fucking corner. You don't even have to low 50. You can push up, you can turn left now. And if he goes, he just hit it, and then you turn left, you haven't went it towards your net. So if he hits it, the ball goes like this. You go like that, so you can go for the fucking ball and have possession, right? Never fucking jump for this ball. Because the thing, what could happen here is, like, let's go through all the options, right? You hit it over him, which means the ball's gonna go over him. And, like, if he just goes back, he's gonna be back. What could happen is he challenges. If you go for a 50, you lose a 50, you get scored on. If you win the 50, you probably score, because he's the last man. I do not like those odds, because you don't have to. If there's 5 seconds left, go for it. But, you know, you have to know, if he just goes back, then he'll be fine, right? So all you have to do is, like, make him think you go up, and then let him go away. And if he fucking goes for it, then let him go. You just go back, you grab ball. Like, going back is the best thing, because you cover everything. If he goes back, you have free ball. If he hits, you go like left, you have momentum towards the net, so you can hit it, right? You don't just hit it, because now you're in a position where, like, he could go, I could go, but it's, like, kind of fucked. What's up, young dairy farmer? You didn't win that fight. I hate you. The touch is kind of ugly. Like, you could score this easily. You should be aware of the fact that you do not want to go for this anymore. It's either, like, you go now, you try to shoot it, but, that, like, he could go, so he could fuck you up. So at that point, you should go back now. Stop driving up and wait here. Let him hit this. And if he doesn't hit it, then you can push up a little bit. But, like, sitting so close doesn't do anything. And it's fine. You notice this happens. When this happens and you're this far up, you're not going to generate enough power to get, like, a good shot on target. Especially when he has full boost and you have 20, right? So you can't just shoot this instantly on target. It's not going to work. So maybe you try to get the boost. That's unlucky. I'll go for the mid boost. Grab it. It's not about the ball. It's no one cares about the ball. The ball has its trajectory. When this happens, instantly flip for the mid boost. Instantly. When he gets a flip on the ball, look, grab the boost, right? Flip towards the fucking mid boost. Grab the mid boost. Fake challenge at the mid boost. Go for the back boost, right? It's not that hard. You flip here, grab all these pads, you grab this shit. You go like this, and then you go back, right? And you grab this shit. If he's still here, you fake challenge, you go back. If he's not here, you know, maybe you could challenge if you see the ball is there. You don't want to always fake challenge, but I'm just saying, if he's there and he's threatening, you don't have to challenge instantly there yet. Control disconnected again. But at least fucking grab the maples, because now you're giving him free maples. You have to fake challenge here, or challenge for real. It's up to you. Good. If you notice you can challenge, then you can challenge. This is a good challenge moment, to be fair, because he drops it down, you just fake yourself, you go too high, and you flip away from the ball. So you always want to flip from a position where you're covering your net, right? So let's see what your challenge is, right? So by flipping right, what do you cover? You cover this part of the ball. And let's see, are you covering your net? No, your whole fucking net is here, dog. So you want to always flip through the ball coming from net, not... Like, this is fine, but you need to flip through the ball, and also need to be a little bit more towards the left side of the ball, so you, again, cover the goal. Because, again, you can really tell you're on the right side of the bar, you're not really doing anything, right? Like, getting comfortable with challenges will come with time. You just have to, like, actively think. I know it's hard, I know you get nervous, but work on it. You'll get better, man. Keep playing, dude. Try to come from net a little bit more, try to flip through the ball. You can get a touch, you can follow up. I would flip into the boost. It's a nice try, at least. Go for back boost now, I'd say. You're not gonna score that. Should be a goal for him. Wait, what? No, he missed. He shouldn't pull the trigger, dude. He shouldn't pull the trigger. Get a fucking touch. You can follow. You have so much time. Like, all you have to do is literally make a turn like this. Jump, like, hit the ball without jumping and flipping. Don't hit it too far away and then follow it up. Don't flip into the fucking... He still scores. What happened, bro? No, you miss. And then he scores. Unlucky. I mean, yeah, you have to go for that. But, like, from the angle you come from, it's already fucked. Like... Like, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. It's just a mechanical miss. It's not really anything I can say. You have to hit those, dog. It's not really anything I can say. You should angle your car maybe more towards the ball before you jump off. Because at the moment when you jump, it's like... This is when you jump. And your car is like... It's not like... I don't know, dude. I don't know what to say, to be fair, dog. Like, I'm basically saying either get higher on the wall or tilt your car more towards the ball. But it's probably be more, like, be higher on the wall because you're way too low and you're, like, not reaching it. But it's like a mechanical error. It's, like, so hard to tell someone be higher on the wall because, I don't know, you just need to know how to hit the ball. And it's not, it'll come with experience, just play it, make these mistakes a lot. You'll get mad at yourself for it. So you're going to learn from it. It's a desperate shot. It's not going to go in. Take it back with you. Why do you not just flip into this ball and fucking hit it like back here somewhere? Back here, everything here is fine. This is a green area. You hit it there and you're fine. Why do you do it so weirdly? Now you can't fucking go for this anymore. Grab your freaking back boost before challenging. To be fair, you scored now, so I guess I should shut up. But it's like you have to realize if you do get a 50 here, right? Like if you get a 50 here, right? If he flips through the pads here, he flips like this, he grabs these pads, he flips again, he grabs this pad, he has 24 boosts, he pushes up a little bit more. If he challenges you here, instead of flipping like a fucking dummy head and landing behind the 50, if he grabs these pads, you know, and he comes here and he challenges you, even if you win the challenge, you know, or the ball like dies here, he grabs this boost, he has full boost, you know, it works because he's dummy head, but make sure you grab the fucking back boost before you do any challenges and any stuff most of the time. Unless of course it's free, but he could have reached. Right? He just flips away. You're pretty dumb. It's like, first of all, have momentum towards the net. You literally turn towards the hit now, and then you're like, oh fuck, I have to turn a little bit more towards the net. You never want to fly away from the net. Because look at the distance of my camera. Look at the crossbar and look at where my position of the camera is going. So if you go away from net, you turn away from net, you're going to fly in a position like this. From this position, you see the difference, you see the gap. If I fly towards this, or if I fly up in the air and I'm here, if I'm here, I have to hit the ball earlier, which means the ball has more chance to go over your head. Whereas if you're more towards the goal line, you'll have a bigger chance of saving it. So don't turn your car, like, away from the net, you know, have momentum towards the net, right? And then you also jump up into the bump. This is like one of the fucking dumbest things you can do, and if you weren't so fucking lucky, you would have bumped you, so you need to be aware of this shit. Maybe go on the backboard. Even though backward is kind of committing, but it's like fine. To be fair, he's high up in the air. This is fine to go on the backboard for, I feel like. And then we get this session today and you just challenge from the backboard. If the ball's like kind of like crossbar-y level or higher, I feel like you could go on the backboard. You don't have to challenge there. Don't fucking ever do that ever again. You're last, man. You can't just challenge the defender when he fucking comes off the wall. If he beats you, he gets a goal because there's a whole map behind you. If you beat him, the ball could be won somewhere around here, it could go like here and over the net, and you won't even fucking get a goal. So you sometimes get a goal if he misses. Yeah, but there's a higher chance you'll get scored on from this, so you don't go for these, dude. Unless, again, there's 10 seconds left and you need a goal, but otherwise you don't really... You don't hit. Well played. You're not gonna get the boost because that's a bad touch. Stop, like, don't get this touch instantly. You don't have boost, and he's gonna know you wanna hit it there. So, since, you know, it's so predictable, try to, like, wait, and if he goes for the corner boost in that corner, then you can maybe, like, turn around and come down on this side. And otherwise, you can, like, try and, like, make him stay on that side and go for the corner boost. You have zero fucking boost, grab some pads, dummy hit. Also, like, don't flip up on the wall. Like, you hit the one, you flip up. Like, flip forward instead of, like, flipping towards the left or some shit, like... You flip forward, you land like somewhere around here, but now you flip like diagonal to the left, which means you kind of like, you have no momentum, you will come down even slower than normal. And grab some pads when you land, homie. And you can't just fucking challenge, it's not threatening. Alright, so, it's not threatening. You just push up, you turn left here at this moment, or turn right, whatever you're comfortable with. Turn left is probably good, but since you pushed up too far, you don't have any boost. This is actually kind of cucked for you because you're already really far up. The second you land, you should pay attention to, like, I can't really challenge you. He gets it over, you should be able. You desperate fucking cuck, dude. I'm not gonna score that. You're also desperate, dude. He's rotating, he's back now. He's back. To be fair, if you got a really good boomer on this, this would have been a goal. But 12 boost, champ 2. I don't mind you trying, because it could have been a goal, it was scoreable. Don't. I mean, it's the same shit here, but it's like, you can fake jump up and like, make him awkward, make him go away and try to get a touch, you can follow up instead of shooting instantly, should have gone for the boost here. Shooting instantly is like, if you do it, then it works, but it's like, if you don't, then it's give away possession, go for boost here, why the fuck would you ever challenge here? Go like this, you're here, go like this. Turn around, you fake challenge, you try to make him hit it here, you grab this boost, if he doesn't hit it, you fake challenge again. If he doesn't hit it, grab this boost, fake challenge again, go to net, try to save a flick, right? If you fake challenge and he never fucking flicks, then you have to challenge sometime. Try to not challenge after this turn, because it's like fucking predictable, right? But yeah, you don't really want to stay around here and wait for a fucking touch. Like, what the fuck does that do? Grab the boost and turn around and try to, like, get ball possession. But make sure you grab this boost and then you turn around. Boost grab first and then something, right? Because now he gets boost. Put this into your corner. Don't put it into mid. It's not going to do anything. If he has a fucking brain, he won't let you do that. Since he doesn't have a brain, he's going to let you do it. Look at this. All he has to do is fucking drive into a position. Like, turn like this, and now wait here. If you go up and you hit this to the side, he just goes here. He grabs his boost, he turns, his ball's gonna bounce here and there, and then he could shoot on you because you're gonna land here with 6 boosts. And 6 is basically the same as fucking 6, and he'd be there, he'd have beaten you to the boost, and he would get a free goal. He hits it way too. Why am I replay analyzing him, dude? He gets a really bad touch in 3, so you have a free challenge. Good job. You kind of don't flip through the ball again. I mean, you kind of do, but you, like, you're too much, like, to the front, so you don't like flip into the ball. Like, you should have hit the ball there with like the corner of your shit, but you like let it go behind you, let it go like past you. I don't know how to explain. Make sure you like flip like fucking dead on in the middle of the fucking ball. Risky challenge. Turn right now. I mean, you can maybe score from this, yeah, but it's like, you could also get scored on really hard, right? I mean, where the fuck, what is even happening? How far did I go, dude? I don't remember these plays, dude. Alright, here we are. Why was it like, it went so far ahead, dog? So I would go like this. challenge like this and then turn like this, or challenge like this and turn like this. But if you turn like this, you're upfield, right? So I would definitely challenge like this and then go back, right? So then when you do that, he'll go for this fast hit. Look at this scuffed ass hit from him. He's gonna get a really bad hit, and you'll be turning like this now. So even if he gets a hit on target, you have momentum towards the net. He'll get a hit, and you just go after his hit, right? Let him get a hit. That's good. This is where you fucking go fast, homie. A little bit fast. You go under the ball. You get a hit that goes here. You go left side of the ball. And you pressure. You can't fucking let him take this much. Like, okay, cool. You're gonna take your time. But this is the moment you fucking get a slight touch like this. Go, come to the left side of the wall and pressure. He has 8 boosts, dude. This is fine. I don't mind him then. Okay, I was gonna say, this is fine. If you actually do take your time, this could still be a goal, even if you get some pads, right? But it's like the first thing you do is still boom it away. My controller needs to stop disconnecting, bruv. Like, try to hit it after the bounce, try to control it, try to, like, low 50 if he challenges, but at least wait for him to challenge. Like, he doesn't even do anything, you just hit it. Don't turn and boom. Don't turn. If he leaves, he leaves. You could go for the mid boost and then go. Like, he already has boost. So you can go like this and then turn around and go from this position. But wait for him to go. Now you get a touch into him, which means you can challenge. Or it could mean he fake challenges and you get pressured by it, so you give the ball away. So that's what happens because you're scared. It's your own fault for hitting it into him, right? You're not controlling. You're just hitting and then seeing, oh fuck, I kind of hit it and now I hit it away. Go for boost, homie. Go for back boost. 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 I don't know how many times I need to say it, but. With 0 boost is kind of a good luck, homie. Don't go. That's enough. If he hits it, he's gonna hit it into the corner. You'd have to challenge. If he challenges and you hit it behind him, it doesn't do anything. Well, good job. It doesn't do anything. It's delaying ball possession. Or delaying giving away ball possession. Where you could literally... I know you have 0 boost, but it's not threatening, you know? If he hits this, he's outplaying himself. And if he doesn't hit it, you can, like, stay with the ball at least. Try to low 50 to try to make him overcommit. Really bad. Why didn't you have momentum towards the shot? Like, why don't you boost now? Why don't you boost now? Why don't you boost now? Why are you like waiting for, like, it's as if you're waiting for like a rumble power up. Like, you're just watching the ball and waiting for like a fucking plunger or some shit. Like, why don't you fucking drive and go for it? Why do you like wait 3 seconds and then go for your boost? So if you jumped up early, you could have maybe grabbed the boost and now you push up towards the hit. You don't respect the outplay. He lands here, he's gonna get a hit now, so don't push up. You stop there. Let him get a hit. If he never gets a hit, you can go after he doesn't get a hit. But when he gets a hit, you need to be back. You don't push up into the hit. He gets a hit, you get outplay. Well played to him. But you shouldn't. That shouldn't have really happened. Grab the boost. Flip, homie. Flip, homie. You were in front of him. It was your boost, but you didn't flip. Don't go. That's open. Well played. Why is everyone in chat just fighting, dog? You don't challenge those. You could fake challenge and then go back, but there's no way you're gonna hit the challenge, homie. You go like this, and now you go back, and you try to, like, have momentum towards the net. Again, point your car, like, inside your net, so you fly always towards your net. Again, the same shit. Chelsea, why are you fighting me? You dummy, I'll beat you hard, dog. If you beat me, Chelsea, I'll get sad. So you haven't went towards an after fake challenge. You don't challenge this. Why? Because he literally has the ball in his car. It's like, look at how far you are. Look at how, like, you could flick right now. And you're jumping from that position, and your whole goal is open. You come from the side. Look at this, again. This is your goal. This is what you need to defend. Look at where you challenge from. Like, this whole shit is open. That's why you can't go for it. I'll kick your ass. That sounds kind of hot. But please don't. You just get lucky that the flick is shit. Again, you can shoot, you can get a hit, you don't turn into the hit. Turn left, turn left, turn left. Nope, let me turn right, you can shoot it in. You just get lucky that he sucks. You can shoot, good position in net. Too fast, dog. You wait back here. Like, this is why it's a good position in net, is because you go so deep. So if he shoots it, you're fine. I would be more here instead of here, turning. Because he could still shoot right there, and you're not really respecting his shot completely. I would wait in a position like this, face towards the plate, so if he shoots it, the ball will come towards you and you're ready, right? So there, the bounce, he could boom it here after bounce, just like he did earlier there, right? You didn't expect to turn towards it. Same mistake here. So you could shoot it after the bounce, you need to be aware of it, so you need to be in a position like this. When he gets a touch like that, then you push out, and then you could go for a straight challenge, right? I feel like since you're playing so fast, you're like playing like like that's how you play. It's like way too fucking fast, and he gets a free fake. Does he suck that much, dude? He must be so mad, dude. Like all he has to do is like fucking hit it. Hit it softly and you're fine. You literally get a goal, dog. Like just jump up, get a single jump, hit it, like fucking softly tap it in front of the net, land, score. You're not gonna score. Don't go for a shot. Mid boost grab, dog. There is no point in waiting for the ball if it's not threatening. If like think ahead of time. You are gonna have to fucking wait for this ball. So go for the mid boost and then wait for the ball. Don't wait for the ball and do nothing. Because you can go for waiting for the ball and grabbing the boost as well. He's gonna be here. Let him hit. It doesn't really matter. You have to be aware of the bump. So you grab the boost and then you leave. You don't stay in the corner where he could fucking bump you, right? So you go like this. You should have turned earlier. And then you go like this, you grab the boost and you go like this, right? And you turn in front of your first post. Instead of like sitting around here and turning here, you go like this and you go back. So you have momentum towards the net. You don't want to turn before he gets a hit because you could get a hit, right? So you would have momentum towards the net, he would get a hit, and then you're trying to get a save, right? Why is my controller scuffed, dog? Stop disconnecting, please. That should be a goal for him. Rank is this? Champ 2, champ 3. I flex the squirrel. You're the fucking squirrel. I was the cow. Cow is my persona. What's the point? You win the challenge. If he, like, look. You win the challenge. If he doesn't go, he can turn around and he has free ball. If he goes, if you win the challenge, you might get a goal, right? He has boost advantage, so it's like, kind of not good odds. If you lose the challenge, you get scored on, and if you go and he doesn't hit it, you fake, then you get scored on. So there's like multiple options where you get scored on, and there's like a really small chance you'll score from this. Because if he, again, if he just never goes for it, you're not gonna score. He just goes back, he has momentum towards the net, he's fine. So close to grants us a bullying, please. So I'll see your shit, dog. How really? What else, Milena? What for Chelsea help? What should my persona be? I'm such a weeb. I'm not a weeb, dog. Don't question mark me. Yo, Sonar, thank you for continuing gifted sub. Good demo, dude. Not Flix a furry. I'm not a furry, dog. Law Fairy Peak? I love him. I love it. If I do Law Fairy Peak, watch me get 100%. Watch. Law Fairy Peak. Watch. Hey, 36 in another universe would probably be 100. Fuck, dude. That bot is lying. That bot is lying. I love Fairy. Alright. I'm trying to 3 lift him my alt. How do I get Grants in view? Like, why is my controller like fucking broken, dog? Alright. 15 literally fucks you up here. Turn right, turn like. I mean, you kind of have to at this point because it do be threatening a little bit. In this position, it's not threatening anymore. So I would stay around. When it really becomes threatening, you have to challenge. But when it doesn't really get too threatening, you can just go back into the corner and let him hit it there. Middleina, you can't even type. Your commands don't even work. This is a decent hit because you need to hit it there. Good boost grab. You can turn with the ball, kind of. Love the analysis, dude. Thanks for being here, man. Because he's going to bounce up, right? If he's going to bounce up, he's not going to score instantly. Because he's right the fuck there, right? So you could turn left. I mean, you might have gotten demoed. So that works, I guess. Yeah, weak boy. Shut up, dude. Mid boost. Alright, so that's a goal. Alright, well played, I guess. Reserved it. Yeah. I'm sorry. I didn't. My bad. Good job, sis. So. Up on that. Curry Murray, my dog. Chelsea, what the fuck are you doing, dude? Hey, Flix, but grinding once a past week or so again. Finally got my mindset fixed. Thanks for everything you do, man. Thanks for listening, dog. Luck on the grind, man. Wish you all the best. Jump, dog. Jump. He's right the fuck there. This is like. How are you aware of the demo in the corner there, but you're not aware of this one? Like, this one is way easier to notice. Girl power. Shut up. Alright. You need to make him hit it, but you don't want to go. Don't challenge. He could flick. You're already too far up. You do get a fucking goal from it, because he's dumb yet. But it shouldn't have been a goal. Do you not realize? Look. All he has to do, single jump there. and you're fucked. Single jab there, or flick it to the right here, and this is a goal. Like, do you realize he could hit it now, and look at how far you are. It's shit. I'm trying to learn from his expert analysis. Facts. So it's like, it's a really bad challenge. It gives you a goal. Go keep playing one, like keep play ones, and you'll get punished for this, and that's good because you need to get punished for this. Best tip I could give this guy is to not sit on the side if you're low 50. If you're low 50, come more goal side. So what he wants to do if you're low 50 is like go in front of the ball a little bit and like side flip into the ball to the left, right. So you come like this and then you like side flip into the ball. Never just be on the right side of the ball because then you will pinch it. You literally help out. For some reason he didn't jump. Yeah, because you know the opponents, this guy thinks it's like, come on bro, you can't be fucking dumb enough to go for this. Oh my fucking god, he actually goes, and that's you, sister. You're like, oh, I'm happy I went, but you're a fucking dummy head for going. Get too stressed when playing ones, I think, so it's really good practice. You just gotta keep playing, man. You do be analyzing though. We really do be daddy chan. That's a hit into him, bro. It allows him to challenge. It's a hit into him, bro. If he's gonna turn, he's gonna come towards you now. So don't get this fucking touch like that strongly. You can get a touch that goes like this, fine, but get a touch that's yours. It's a precious ball possession, dog. Don't just hit it into him. Now you're cucked. Or don't be a cuck and get closer to the ball. Fake jump maybe so he knows you're going. But you're not even going. You just make him think you're going, right? Jump up earlier and definitely block it. What I would do is jump up earlier so at least you're in the air. Like jump up earlier now. If he goes, you low 50. If he never goes, you just come back down to the ground. Middle-linea, you fucking love Farah. You're like addicted to him almost. It's like that 3%. That's like the small PP, but it's like fine, you know. Maybe you have like enlargement pills and shit, but it's like fine. It's fine. It's fine. Well, you jump up really late, which means the ball will go over your head, which is not really good. You mid boost grab. You can't challenge here. You can't challenge here. Please go back. You pushed up way too far, you know. Turn right here. You can't stay up here. It's either you are more back, so you let him get a hit, and then you turn up left. Or when you're up this far up, you should turn right now and give it up and try again. Here we go again, and then we go back. Here we go again, and then we go back. Here we grab this boost, you go again. But you don't... If you're this far up already, you have to accept you can't go like this and then still go upfield. Like, look at how fucking deep you are in the corner. Like, look. Bruff. Like, look, bruv. But you could have still, like, saved it. That's, like, the worst thing. If you jump up here, you're saving it, but you don't decide to jump it. You, like, let him fucking come down the wall and then shoot. It's kind of sippy. Yeah, it's fine. And now, are you gonna do love me, Milena? And then get, like, 1%? Oh, no. She didn't even do it. You're Fairy Peak fangirl. Is that the end of the game? Did you forfeit, bruv? Oh yeah, you mean you lost the kickoff? Your kickoffs are fucking wank, bruv. I don't know what's wrong with them, boys. You use way too much boost on kickoff anyway. Like, first of all, like, trying to have like 20 boosts left after like a normal kickoff. After diagonals, I have like 10 to 12 boosts left. After the normal kick, I have like 20 fucking boosts left. But it's like, most of your problems were like, challenging when he has a bonus car and not fake challenging, like pushing up way too deep, getting in touch that you can't follow up. Why did I click on that? But I hope you learned something, sis. So just, you know, keep playing ones, try to like think more about your challenges, or try to think more about your fake challenges and shit. Try to think more about like, I don't have to challenge in the corner. Like if it's in the corner and your opponent has the ball, you can just push up, make him think you go and you have momentum towards the net. So if he hits it, you're back. And if he doesn't hit it, turn around, free ball. Now you need to try and get touches, you can follow up, right?